1 Corinthians 7 verse 9, it says, and I quote, "But if they cannot control themselves, they should marry, for it is better to marry than to burn with passion," end quote. In 1969, at Fort Riley Army Base in Kansas, a certain honorable and respected Franciscan priest, 45-year-old man named Marcos Martin Cabrera, a Mexican descent born in Los Angeles, California, was assigned to be the chaplain at Fort Riley Army Base in Kansas, United States of America. He fell to a certain young lady around 24 years in age named Lynn, a Philippine-born American citizen of Junction City, Kansas. She was working as payroll clerk at the same location at Fort Riley Army Base in Kansas. According to a reliable source, Lynn was given roses by the priest around April of 1969. We can speculate that true love existed between the honorable Catholic priest Martin and the military payroll clerk Lynn. Their secret love affair made her pregnant. Due to the complicated situations of Martin and Lynn being in the Catholic Church, Martin kept his duty as a Franciscan priest. We can speculate that it saddened and frightened Lynn, and she struggled but managed to keep her pregnancy hidden from her family. Lynn decided to give up her baby boy Martin Lynn to Holy Family Services for adoption so that she can keep the same narrative of lies that this pregnancy did not happen. 9 months after, on July 21, 1970, Lynn delivered a baby. A baby boy was born in Los Angeles at St. Anne's Hospital, and Lynn named her baby boy Martin Lynn. He was 6 pounds 10 ounces, 20 inches long. God has a plan. He allowed the birth of Martin Lynn safely into this world. We are thankful that during this time in 1970, abortion is prohibited and his biological mother Lynn has no other choice but to carry him for 9 months safely. Here is the photo of Martin Lynn, aka Brett Martin Porter, when he was born. This secret was kept intact. Nobody knows, even after the death of the Franciscan priest, who died from severe stroke while conducting a mass in Las Vegas in April 1991. It seems like none of the two ever confessed to anyone this secret baby produced by their secret love affair. Brett Martin is thankful to his wife for hiring an investigator when he himself had a stroke in 2009. This is to find out his medical history. In 2019, Brett Martin took a DNA test using Ancestry.com, and the results connected him to his biological father's family line. He got some information from some of them and visited the Santa Barbara mission, where his Franciscan priest biological father's remains are kept. Going back to 1971, at the Holy Family services, Martin Lynn survived, and God had spoken to the hearts of Mr. Jack and Mrs. Jacqueline Porter. According to Jacqueline's writings on Martin Lynn's baby book, here is what they did to find a baby they choose to be a part of their family. From a personal handwriting of Mrs. Jacqueline Porter, and I quote, "We saw a notice in our church bulletin about some babies needing homes, and we realized how much we wanted another baby. We called the agency, and they sent a form for us to fill out. Then we went to a group meeting. Next, we had a meeting with Miss Hamilton, and she said very casually that there was a baby who was very personable, but had a problem gripping objects and a few other problems because of palsy. I guess we both knew you were meant for us because we couldn't stop thinking about you. We told the agency we wanted you and they showed us your picture. It was love at first sight for us all. It was agony waiting for our first visit as they changed the first date and we had to wait longer. Our first visit, we were all kind of shy and you wouldn't have much to do with us, but you were so much fun to watch. Here is a photo of you during our first meeting. Our next visit, we took you for a little ride and you did not seem frightened. You did not cry at all. 2 days later we all four went out to breakfast and then to the agency to watch you have a test. Here is a photo of the four of us, who will be your family. You did so well, it was hard not to cry while watching you. They were amazed at how you had progressed in 6 months. Of course, they didn't know how hard we had prayed for those months. We didn't really find you, God sent us to each other. We just weren't interested in any other baby after we knew about you. We named you Brett Martin Porter and you were baptized on January 30, 1972, at the St. Joseph's Church. Your godparents are your sister Cammie and your brother Todd, officiated by Father Raymond M. Hopp. You wore a little white suit with short pants. You look so cute. That night we took you a spaghetti dinner at the church. Cammy was a waitress there. You were throwing all your toys on the floor. From the Holy Family Adoption Agency, this is the way you looked on the day you first came home. Your hair was black, very fine textured. Your eyes were brown, almost black and beautiful. Your complexion was medium and beautiful. You weighed 24.5 pounds. Your height was 32 inches, and you have teeth with a total number of 8. You were wearing a yellow shirt, blue vest, corduroy, and pants, white shoes and a yellow jacket. You were walking very well. You did not cry or fuss or seem the least bit scared. In fact, you seemed as happy with us as we were with you, which was extremely happy. It was instant love for all of us. You shared a room with Mommy and Daddy, but your clever daddy built you a tiny little room in our room out of wood paneling. We decorated in red, white, and blue. We didn't sleep much the first night. Happiness, excitement, and making sure you were okay. The first few nights, you were a little restless, and every noise you heard awakened you. After a week, there was no more problem, and you slept straight through from 7:30 p.m. to 6:30 a.m. The only problem was you were sick for about 3 days, and we had to wake you every 4 hours for medicine. You were very good about it though. Our address where we brought you is at 7401 Kasaba, Canoga Park. I started you eating with a spoon the second day you were home. You accepted cereal after just about 3 tries, but no vegetables or meat. You ate fruit by spoon the third day. Your vegetables and meat, you still took by the bottle. At 18 months you ate all strained foods by spoon, but still, nothing like a cracker or cookie or any hand-fed foods. I started you on going to bed at 7:30 p.m. and you slept until 6:30 a.m. You would go down for a nap right after lunch at about 12 noon and sleep for about 3 hours. At 19 months, whenever I would go to your crib or playpen, you would jump up and down and get so excited. You could do patty cake and you'd take our hands and has us rub your head or pat your face. I changed your doctor to a pediatrician at 20 months. His name is Dr. Robert Braun. He said he didn't believe you had palsy at all. You say the words no, nana, mama, da-da-da, up and high. You could cluck with your tongue and make kissing noises. You can hold a plastic glass while drinking. You could climb up on the couch without help. At 21 months, you run instead of walking. You can say Jews, 1, 2, 9, 10. You pound your chest when we say do Tarzan. We ask where is Grandpa's boy and you pat the top of your head. You say tickle 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 when we tickle you. You throw back the bar of your car seat when we arrive at places you recognize and put it down when we put you in the seat. You love to play ball even with a big basketball. Daddy gave you your first haircut and you were really good about it. Your second birthday, Mr. Rossello, the social worker, made his final visit and his okay for going to court to legalize your adoption. Our house was kind of messed up because we were building your bedroom. Grandma and Grandpa Jocelyn and Nancy came for cake and ice cream at night. Your gifts were as follows. From Mommy and Daddy, tricycle, 2 sunshoots, training pants, new saddle shoes, and toy truck from Cammy and Todd, swimming pool ball and life ring Elsie Cookie and family, green folding chair, bucket and shovel, and books Grandma and Grandpa Johnson, rocking horse and 2 sunshoots Nancy, 2 sunshoots. Suzanne and Jim, card with $1 Grandma and Grandpa Porter $5 You say the word Coke at 26 months you dance to music and play football when we say ready, set, hut. You still love to play catch and read books. At 2.5 years, you could say Todd, Com, Mom, Dad, Boow, Juice, Color, and any word we ask you to repeat. You could recognize all numbers and say them, and most of your letters. At 33 months, you began eating solid foods. The first thing was chocolate candy, then Fritos, tortilla chips, peanut butter, French toast, popcorn, toast, and crackers. The only problem, you stuffed it all your mouth hole, but you chewed very carefully. Your third birthday, Grandma and Grandpa Johnson and Nance came for a birthday party. I baked you a cake you wouldn't blow out the candles or taste it. You sing with the radio and dance and mimic everything and everyone. Your fourth birthday, Grandma and Grandpa Johnson came for dinner. Grandpa was just getting over a heart attack. It was his first trip out. Mommy baked you a cake. You blew out all your candles and ate your cake for the first time. Your fifth birthday, I gave you your first real party. Your guest was Michelle Yasiello, Ryan and Nikki Kwong, Adrenia Lafindi, Karine Okumura, Vincent Michael McGuire, Richard Kropfel, Stuart, David and Lisa Klein, Margie Kropfel, Mart Susie and Julie Kropfel and Elsie McGuire. There were games, prizes, balloons, cake, and ice cream. Your bedtime prayers. In the name of the Father, Son and Holy Spirit, God bless Daddy, Mommy, Cammy, Todd, Brett, and all my grandpas, grandmas, relatives and friends. Help me to be a good boy and thank you for all my nice things. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Amen. End quote. Here is a photo of the loving adopted family of Brett Martin Porter. Brett always states that his mom Jacqueline will forever be his mother and his dad Jack will forever be his father. Today, July 21, 2020, Brett Martin Porter, aka Martin Lynn, turned 50 years old. Here is a side-by-side photo of him and his Franciscan priest biological father Marcos Martin Cabrera, deceased. Here is a photo of him and his biological mother, taken when he surprised her in Kansas on Brett's 34th birthday. Happy 50th birthday, Brett Martin Porter. This animated presentation of your origin was wholeheartedly created with love by your wife Lynn Moran Porter on this 21st day of July, 2020. Lynn Moran Porter, Brett's wife, said, and I quote, "I am super grateful to God and to Mom Jacqueline and Dad Jack for raising you as their son, who also loves God. Mom, thank you for keeping a baby book about Brett with your personally written updates about his development. Brett, I am thankful to be your wife and grateful to God for answering our prayers to have two children, Kyla Victoria and Benjamin Martin." End quote. Benjamin Martin, Brett's son, said, and I quote, "Happy birthday, Dad. I am grateful to you that you did not put me up for adoption, but instead wanted to be my real dad." End quote. Kyla Victoria, Brett's daughter, called to say happy birthday on July 19, 2020, and also on her dad's actual birthday.
It is our intention to reveal the origin of Mr. Brett Martin and to encourage those children who were given up for adoption to not lose hope and faith. We also hope this video may be able to reach out positively to the hearts of those living priests, nuns, and others who gave in to their weaknesses in the past, for them to remember that God forgives, and that you can still come forward, confess and correct your actions, be free, and pray and believe that you can still repent while you are still alive. God has a grand plan for each of us on earth, as it is written in Jeremiah 29 verses 11 to 13. It says, and I quote, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart." End quote. Thank you for watching.